Are we living in a dream world? Are your eyes still green, girl? I know you're sick and tired of arguing, but you can't keep it bottled in. Jealousy, we gotta swallow it. Your heart and mind, baby, follow it. Smile, happiness, you can model it. And when you feel opposite,
you too, what's up? It's your boy CB.
And your girl CeCe.
And welcome back to the CB and CeCe show.
I took my glasses off.
I'm kind of fucking with him a little bit.
Welcome back, guys.
Sure. Something wrong with us. You need to check. American Psycho, part 3.
Anyway, y'all see the title. But before we get into any of that, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell. And if you are watching, fuck you.
Now, that was out of nowhere. But don't forget to hit the notification bell. And you can see when we drop these videos. Before we get into it, we want to shout out Socialite. This is a ring light for your, a selfie ring light for your phone. It's nice. It's pretty high speed. I'm going to add a picture in here so you can see how the effect of this works. So, you know, it's a nice little button you hit. Different, oh, it's real bright.
But I like it a lot, y'all. Seriously. It, so you just get me in all my areas. Your phone.
So, you know, you just throw it on the front of your phone like a little clamp. You know, little selfie. Blah, 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 blah. I know how y'all women like that shit. Some of y'all questionable niggas do, too. And then you'll turn around if you don't
take
got no flash.
Take somebody else's.
But, I know some of you guys got these new high-speed phones that probably have cameras and lights in the front of your phone, but we got iPhone 8s and we don't got cameras in front of our, I mean, lights in front of our phones. So, bam. I know how y'all, especially y'all dudes out here doing their switch and really switching. Anyway.
But yeah, y'all, get the light. It's really nice. Their website, you can just look them up. Look up socialite.com, and they got a lot of lights and stuff like mm-hmm. for your phones. They got actually they have this mirror, y'all. It's a mini mirror with lights on. It's really nice. I was gonna try to get that probably next time. I'm gonna probably get that because I liked it. I was like, oh, that's cute when I'm doing my makeup or whatever, even though I'm not really into makeup. Yeah, I'm trying to learn. I'm getting there, I guess you can say. But anyway, y'all see the title. Excuse me, y'all see the title. Y'all see the title.
We're talking about part 2 out here.
Talking about part 2. This is what
the person who's been cheated.
What on. The victim does, the I guess. Victim. The victim.
This is part 2 to the video we did of what 10 things, or well not 10 things cheaters should do.
The perpetrator
should do, as in to save their relationship / marriage. And this is things that the victim can or should do.
These are things I did, you guys. These are things that I want y'all to do that I feel like that will assist. It's not all. I'm just saying these are things that I did that I felt like helped me. You know, it made me see clear and decide on what I wanted to do as far as my marriage. So the first thing is to decide on whether you're going to stay or not. And that's a hard decision. And a lot of people got to understand that for me just staying in a marriage for me just ain't what I do. Like I said, my marriage is more so, I ain't gonna say we conduct our marriage like a business, but our marriage is like a business. Like we have other factors. It's not just me and him in our marriage. Well, it is just me and him in our marriage.
That did kind of sound like we had other people.
Yeah. It is just me and him in our marriage. But I'm saying we have kids. We have, you know, we got wheels and we got a lot of shit tied and intertwined with each other. We ain't really got too much time to just be like, all right, this is it. Like, I don't anyway. I ain't got that time, kind of time. So, you know, I think that the person who is going to stay, if they're going to stay, they need to make that a decision. And don't get me wrong, it's not going to be a decision you're going to make in a month, maybe not even 2 months, but you have to make a decision on whether you're going to work this out or you not. Because if you're going to work it out, that means you're going to stay. And if you're going to stay, you have to start doing those things, because the things that you're going to do to get back to normal aren't going to be the same things you would do if you leave. Mm. So I think that's number one. That's the first thing that y'all need to do. The second thing is don't worry about the details. And what I mean by that is that sometimes as women, and I know men probably too, but a lot of time as women, we want to know, like, well, not necessarily, oh, what was it that you liked about her, but we want to know when, where, how, did it feel good, did y'all do this, did y'all do that. And I'm not saying, y'all, that a lot of questions aren't necessary. That's not what I'm saying. But I am saying is you want to sometimes, like, you want to not – not I ain't gonna say guard yourself from that hurt, but don't get into too many details, because it ain't, if you stand with him and all that shit and he telling you he not gonna do it, that's what you focusing on. We ain't doing that shit no more, so it ain't important. We worrying about what me and you doing. We not worrying about you, what you and her did or what you and him did. For some of us who don't mind our husbands or men dating other men, I'm not with that shit, but you know I'm saying to whoever. I think also number three thing I got is find out why he cheated. And I know this is going to be a hard thing for, I don't want to say it's hard for the man. It might be hard for the man. I'm not for sure, but I know it's hard for us to accept some answers. And what I mean by that is, like, for me, it was really hard for me to understand that Charles did what he did and that it had nothing to do with me. Like, it was hard because I'm thinking, like, well, who does that? Like, I know I'm not going to cheat on Charles because I don't want to put my marriage in jeopardy like that. So I felt like, well, damn, why couldn't he feel the same way? But his thinking was not, it had nothing to do with me. His thinking was literally like, oh, she's not going to find out. And if she doesn't find out.
And like I was saying before, to say something about that, because that was really major on why they did it or why you did it. Be honest about it. But at the same time, me, I was really trying to guard my shame and her, not her shame, but just guard the situation, to sugarcoat the situation, even though you can't sugarcoat it. I lied a lot about it, but not why I did it. I just lied about the situation. Oh, I just did this and went on. But when it came to why I did it, it was no reason why other than that's what I wanted to do. You know what I'm saying? And that took a long time for me to get her to understand that. Well, I don't think I got her to understand. I think that's something she had to.
I don't feel like it took you a long time for me to understand it. I think that the problem with why you did is it took you so long to tell the truth. Mm-hmm. So with you, it was always how hard it was for mm-hmm. me, because I'm always trying to understand when in all actuality I shouldn't be the one trying to understand. You should be the one explaining. You know what I'm saying? So I think that was our problem. But I get what you're saying too. I understand that.
That's hard.
But yeah, so I think that sometimes if it is a bigger issue than something y'all can handle, then counseling is definitely a plus. Because sometimes, again, y'all, I think that a lot of us, we go off of what we see, and not intentionally. Sometimes I've never seen a successful marriage besides on TV. I've never seen a faithful husband besides on TV. And again, being that I know what real life is, even on TV, I'm assuming he cheating, because that's what I've always saw. You know what I mean? I've never seen a man faithful to his wife, or I've just never seen that. So I think with me, that's my problem, being that I'm not necessarily saying that it's normal, but I am saying that it's normal in a way. And I think that's something, I guess maybe I have to work on myself. I don't feel like it's a problem. Some people feel like it's an issue. A lot of women feel like, oh my gosh, she's just saying it's okay, when that's not what I'm saying. But I feel like, you know, cheating happens. I feel like shit happens in the marriages, and I feel like if you ain't gonna do nothing in a marriage, you're gonna always have to forgive. Like, you're gonna forgive so much. Like, yeah, I'm forgiving Charles for cheating, but it's so much other little shit or major shit that he might forgive me for. Who knows? You know what I'm saying? Like, I could hurt his feelings by saying certain words, because I'm a real blunt person. So being that I'm a real blunt person, sometimes I say things out of my mouth that I don't take personal, but some people do take personal. But I really just take it as nothing. So yeah, number four, I think that we need to make it extremely clear about how we feel. I personally feel like when me and Charles first started going through this, I felt like I wasn't allowed to, I wasn't able to, because of his own selfishness. As he kind of said it a little bit in his video, I wasn't allowed to let him know how it hurt me, because I wanted to work our marriage out so bad. I didn't want to be the, I don't want to say, yeah, I didn't want, and this ain't gonna make no sense, y'all, but I didn't want to be the villain. Even though I'm the hurt one, I didn't want to be the villain. So I didn't want him to know, like, at first, like, oh, well, you fucking broke me. Like, you just did the ultimate. Like, God, this is the exact same thing I told you not to do. Like, you know, so I held a lot of my feelings down because I didn't want him to be so uncomfortable, which it shouldn't have, it had nothing to do with him. But that's just me as a person. I'm a people's pleaser. So being that I have that aspect of me already, when I care about something or care about somebody, even with my kids, I do that. So that's something I have to work on with myself, I guess. But yeah, and he kind of, I guess once the counselor pointed it out to him, I guess he seen it differently and he worked on it too. So that was a plus. Work on yourself. I feel like also, y'all, like, not saying that, I feel like with Charles, I think he just had a lot of opportunity, and I think that's something that I have to learn to do, because I do. I'm really kind of like, if Charles say, oh, I'm going to the store, and that's what he say, going to the store, I just put in my head, like, all right, he going to the store, and I leave it at that. So I won't call, I won't say nothing. He can be gone for 12 hours, and I just won't say shit, because I'm thinking he's just gone to the store. So I think that some of us, I'm just exaggerating, y'all. I'm exaggerating saying 12 hours.
At the end of the day, you're right, and now I fucked that up, so now.
And that's a problem with me. I've always kind of been like, because I always think everybody's like me. So being that I think that that me and Charles are equal, we're the same, I feel like, shit, I ain't about to go do nothing. It's stupid, and my husband not know about it. So if he's gone for 12 hours, I'm thinking in my head, he's like me. So he ain't about to do nothing stupid shit. So it ain't no, you know what I mean? Now, don't get me wrong, if we get late, then I might call, like, babe, you all right? Everything good? But I really ain't that kind of person that you got to just call every 10 minutes, like, hey, what's up? Like, I'm here. I don't operate like that. So I kind of feel like me being so kind of like whatever, I feel like sometimes maybe I gave him a lot of opportunity to do that. Like a lot of door opens, because I just like, oh, he got to be like, man, I can just tell Cherish I'm going to the store and she going to be good. And that's not always good, y'all. So I feel like that we need to work on ourselves too. Find stuff that we feel like we're not doing the best in, and we need to try to fix it. Now, I'm not saying everything's going to be perfect, because it's not, and we all know that. But I am saying that we can try to perfect whatever we feel like we have wrong in the relationship. And I feel like I leave a lot of room for shit for him to just do whatever, because, oh, I'm about to go out, Cherish. Okay.
But to say that, I don't think that's something you need to fix. I think that's a privilege that a husband should have with his wife. To say what he gonna do and not be second guessed, you gotta handle that right. You gotta handle that appropriately and be considerate of, not you, I'm talking about me.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Be considerate of it, grateful of it. Don't take it for granted. Don't mishandle it. You know what I'm saying? Because now, I be pissed. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I still don't say anything.
You don't
to
say
you,
anything,
though.
But certain things I may say. Like, call and text you about where I'm at. Like, one time I said something. She was like, you saying this to me for what? I said, I believe. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I don't know how others feel, but for myself, when I knew, I was like, man, I'm doing the right thing, it didn't even fucking matter. You know what I'm saying?
Well, because that's what you have to understand. That's my main problem. Like, I have to, that's something that I hate that I have to worry about. Like, I have to worry about what my husband's doing. What is my husband doing when I don't know? That's what I have to worry about. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to worry about that. Like, that's not a case. You know what I'm doing.
Too.
But how?
What
about
I do?
But how? You've never had to, not with me, I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Like, what?
I mean, you ain't out here twerking and popping it on nobody, all kind of stuff.
Where I'm going to be popping it at, Charles?
In the bed? I don't know. FaceTime?
Right.
Google Duo?
Right. You a fucking clown.
But no, seriously. And like I'm saying, I don't have to worry about that with her. And people, you know, coworkers would be talking about stuff. And they look at me like, this nigga don't even know. I'll be like, no, I don't got to worry about that with my wife, for real.
Because yeah, I'm really, like, really boring,
you know,
y'all.
And everybody else be like, oh, this nigga think he... And his wife probably the main one. I don't even elaborate in it. You know what I'm saying? I'll be like, all right. You know what I'm saying? Because I know what kind of wife I got. And it's hard to find a wife like that, to be honest. Dealing with the women I've dealt with, the number of women I've dealt with before in my life, you're not even gonna find. And I don't think I knew how to appreciate it. I didn't know how to receive it. That's what it was. I didn't know how to receive it and handle it. It was too much for me. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know how to receive it and handle it. And it starts with your mama. And so that says a lot for me. So it took a lot for me to handle that, to receive that, you know what I'm saying?
That's good. Thank you for sharing that. Number six, y'all, is I got do not, you're not going to forget, but you need to try to let it go. And what I mean by let it go is you can't over obsess about it, because if you over obsess about it, it's going to show up in your daily actions. Because sometimes we can be walking somewhere, y'all, and something can remind me of something, and I think about it, and then now I'm here, and now I got an attitude with him after we having this great day. It happens like that. So you have to intentionally put it in your head that you're not worrying about what you feel anymore. Like, you're not worrying about, oh, I think he's still cheating, or is he? Because if you're gonna feel like that and you ain't gonna let that shit go, who wants to live like that? You don't want to live like that, and you don't want him to live like that, because that ain't doing nothing but torturing both of y'all. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that you shouldn't be like, oh, I'm he don't be stupid. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying by no means be stupid, but I am saying be, you know, kind of let this shit go. If you feel, you know what I mean? If it's something you feeling, you tell him. You ask him. Don't, you know, oh, that's why he ain't answering his phone. Like, oh, he ain't answering his phone because it is. Don't do all that. It ain't that serious. You know, you text him. If he don't answer, he'll respond to you in a minute. When you see him, you ask him and you go from there. But don't make yourself so miserable worrying about what he's doing and what you think he's doing and how you think he's doing it. Like, that's definitely not going to put y'all relationship. Leave it in there a little bit longer, baby. Sorry, y'all. That's definitely not going to, you know, put you in a better situation. Number 7 is accept what he or she is telling you. Do not keep wondering or overthinking. I'm saying this, y'all, because a lot of times, and I'm only saying this if you staying with the person, because if you leave, now it's really hard with Charles, because again, as we said, he lied a few times, so it's really hard. But again, I'm a real understanding person, so what's my I feel like for me, I need to work on that myself. But when a person tell me something, I always feel like, oh, well, I wouldn't do that. So they would. And that's not true. A motherfucker would do it. Like, they will. And I know it's crazy, but I really feel in my heart sometimes. I do like, well, I wouldn't do that. So I wouldn't expect anybody else to do that to me.
That's the part where I be trying to explain. People try to, myself, not trying to explain to you that everybody, not you.
No, and I remember that. I remember
everybody,
one time.
Everybody, me. Majority of people are me.
I remember.
The less majority. This amount of people, I'm saying, out of 10 women, probably only one is you. If that.
Well, I don't.
I'm not trying to disrespect no women on here looking at this, but I'm just being honest. I throw a 2 out there then. 2 women. I'm going to be real. There's a lot of good women out there, but if you just grab 10 random ones, it's only probably 1 or 2 that's going to be like her. If you feel like you're one of them women, congratulations. But I'm just saying.
Well, okay, so what I'm saying is, y'all, one time we were moving, and it was crazy because it was Charles and his cousin. You know, they grew up in the same place. I grew up in Ohio, so we were moving, and didn't somebody steal our bike?
Somebody stole a B-bike, son's bike.
Somebody right.
She left the bike on the back of the house. We had no fence. It's an open yard, and she left the bike in the backyard, basically. Only thing somebody had to do was run out there, grab it, and get on and ride off. It was no gate to jump. It was nothing, no dogs, anything. And the next day she said, who would do that? Who would steal from someone that they don't know? And that's when we lived, said, that's the reason why they did it. They don't fucking, and then people steal from people they do know.
And
so
I,
what makes,
and y'all listen, I get
them.
It. I totally get it. But I just was thinking, like, why the fuck would you, like, I'm not about to go steal nobody's bike. Like, I'm just not about to go do that. Then it's a whole kid's bike. And these people just moved in. Like, I just don't want to, like, why do you do that? But see, let me say this, y'all. I promise you, that's why my karma in my life is just so, and I'm not saying my shit is perfect. I'm not saying that, but I promise y'all, I be having bad shit happen like everybody else, but my shit don't never overlap. Like, my shit, everything always ends up okay for me all the time, especially financially, always, because I feel like that's what the universe gives me back because of all that I give what I put in the world.
But with that being said, you gotta stop thinking that people are you.
Correct. You are correct.
People have the same
I'm a little naive sometimes. I am. Just like with your, well, yeah, you're right.
You
you're right.
Sometimes?
You think I'm naive all the time?
When it comes to certain things, yeah. If it comes to a particular item, yes. Now, when it comes to other stuff, no. Okay, like financial shit, no. You know what I'm saying? You know, street stuff, you're street smart, but when it comes to, I guess, people's intentions, you suck at that. And I come out, and I come off as the bad guy, because I say, no, Cherish, that motherfucker. And you, and the first thing she said is, everybody not you.
Well, because I have, this is what I have to explain to Charles. Just like one time, I'm not going to say no names, but it was a certain somebody that Charles just did not want me to get close to. And I figure, like, this person was a, you know what I mean, at the end of the, day, that me and this person is going to be in each other's life, whether we want it or not. And he told me not to. He was like, you're going to get burnt by this person, don't do it. But I just didn't see it like that. Like, I just was like, you know what, Charles, you ain't the only person that can change. Everybody changes. Everybody goes through different stuff. Everybody goes through stuff, and everybody comes out of stuff differently. So I always try to give people that, you know what I mean? Because I want people to give me that too.
So what happened?
I'm not the same person that I was 2 years ago. So since I'm not that same person, give me that same, give me a benefit of the doubt sometimes. Now, don't get me wrong. Charles was right about this particular, well, Charles is right about a lot of people, but let me explain by this, y'all. These are people that he know, people that he's from, that he's from with, and he knows them.
And that's
so
why,
that's why I probably
why
should have, yes. That's probably why I should have, you know, been in, I should have took it in consideration. But I just don't be thinking about shit like that. I really don't, y'all. I just be thinking that, you know, I just don't be thinking like that. So that's
and why. And when it comes to men too, that's not where I'm from. It's men in general. One time,
to an extent.
One time was a man. He was so called bad down in his luck. He had kids involved. That's her soft spot. He had kids. He a single dad, and he needed help. They were trying to take his kids or some shit. And she was like, "Oh, I got you." And they went out to, I said, "Cherry, what the fuck? This nigga want to go out to eat with you for like what you?" This before, way before we were married. We were just dating then. And no, it's not even like that. I said, "Cherry, this nigga trying to fuck you. I promise you that." No, how dare you? And then guess what happened? They went out to eat, and she called me crying. "Oh my God, he really did try to holler at me, fuck me, oh God.
That, first of all, it was not like that. Don't make it seem like it was like that. It was not like that. He did tell me that, but I thought that the guy was focused, because at this time I was working for
Clarksville. My grandma would get there.
I was working for the county at the time. I was working for the county in the daycare at the time, so it was just a situation, but that's not always true. But anyway, let me get back to my question. I'm on number 8. This is important, y'all. I don't even know why this is number 8, because I got it written more than once. But be honest about your feelings with yourself, and be honest with the person, and don't hold it. Like, if you feeling mad that day, tell that person you feeling mad that day, and that's okay. Be honest about your feelings. If you don't want to get out of bed and you feeling depressed, that's okay. I'm just now able to feel like that, y'all. And some days I feel like I don't want to get up out of bed. Some days I feel like I just don't want to move. Some days I feel like I want to go running. Some days I feel like I want to go shopping. And whatever I fucking feel like doing, that's what I'm doing. Like, I really don't have a...
You ever wake up and feel like you want to...
Some days I just feel like, you know, whatever, and I go with that. So be honest about your feelings and let that person know, you know, today. Or, you know what, y'all, this is a really good example. Charles is always on his phone. And again, I've never been a person who checked phones. Like, I've just never had to. I've never been that kind of a person. But when Charles is on his phone, sometimes we could be watching a movie and we're supposed to be spending our time together. And at 9 o'clock, we're not supposed to have phones, but his phone be on the side of the bed. So sometimes when it vibrates, I hear it. And I be like thinking to myself, like, is that her? I don't know who the fuck her is, you guys. I just, whoever the fuck her is. Like, that's always a thought. So I had to move out my own way, and I had to tell him how that made me feel. I told him, I said, "Charles, that really aggravates me, mm-hmm. and it makes me feel like it's women texting you on your phone." And it might, again, y'all, it ain't got nothing to do with shit, but that's just how I felt at that time.
It'd be ESPN 9 times out of 10.
It could, right. But I'm still wondering, like, so when, and y'all, this is something else, y'all, this is so weird, and I don't know why. And so one of my friends, I'm not going to say her name, but one of my friends said, "Cherish, I ain't going to lie to you, but how come he didn't?" Because I always wondered, like, when did Charles have time to cheat? And my friend told me, she said, "Cherish, you let your husband do whatever." And I'm like, "What? He a grown ass man. Like, how am I supposed to stop him from doing whatever? He tell me what he gonna do, and I tell him okay. If I don't like it, if I'm not okay with it, I let him know I'm not okay with it. But he still gonna do what he wants, because he a grown ass man. Just because you married to somebody don't mean you got a motherfucking lock and key on that person either, y'all. Like, that's a lot." So when she told me that, I kind of did think, like, well, damn, I always do. If we got plans and some other plans come up and Charles got other plans, I usually be like, "All right, that's cool," and I leave it alone. But now I need to be more, you know what, Charles, no. I want us to do whatever it was that we're going to do. Like, I need to be more forceful with that.
But to say that, but in 9 times out of 10, we're going to do what you want to do, though.
Yeah, now, but before it wasn't like that. Before, because I never really, I just said, whatever.
And just because I can't hold my tongue, the people who say that shit, who be having that so-called lock and key on their husband, they be the main ones doing this shit. But I'm going to share that. They both be fucking in a second, but it's not good.
This one, y'all, some of y'all are not going to agree with, and I totally understand, but I said, try to be understanding. Remember, it's not your fault at all, but listen to understand versus to respond. Everyone isn't you. And that's important for me, just because, like, in my heart, I be thinking, like, damn, how could you do that to somebody for so long and not say anything? Like, I don't know, y'all. I be feeling kind of, like, you know what I mean? I really love Charles. Like, so I can't see myself being, like, all...
How much?
I can't see too much.
That mean you'll kill me? You got potential to kill me?
Probably so.
Yeah, I hear that. I am in perfect health. I drive with my seatbelt on. I don't.
You text and drive.
Not that much.
Not that much. And he's stopping, y'all. We get this.
I'm not in any kind of dangerous activity. So if something happens and they tell me some nigga was found dead, 9 times out of 10, she did it. Carry on.
Whatever, y'all. But yeah, so just because you the person that's hurting, and just because you the person, that person might be hurting too. Because y'all got to remember, hurt people hurt people. So, you know, again, I know Charles didn't cheat on me to intentionally hurt me. He cheated on me because that's what he wanted to do, and it was a new feeling, and it was just there, and the opportunity was there, and that's just what it was. So, me trying to be understanding to that is not necessarily understanding that he just said, fuck it, or nothing. But it's just me being understanding and accepting the situation for exactly what it is, and leaving it there. Second, y'all, let the shit go. Shit happens. Mistakes happens. Go on with your positive life and focus on your good marriage. And that's what y'all gonna focus on. The first time, y'all, I say is definitely the worst time, and I think that should be the last time. And hopefully y'all can get into a better relationship by being honest with each other from there on out.
But I have a question. Mm-hmm. What do you do if the person who cheated first, right? Okay, I said it wrong. What happens if the victim becomes a cheater?
And that can happen. And that can happen too sometimes. But I feel like if a person comes in with good intentions, again, the person who's been cheated on, if that person's got her intentions or his intentions right, my intentions is to work on my marriage. That's what they supposed to be doing. So if they become a cheater, then maybe that marriage ain't what they supposed to be having. Right. I mean, I feel.
I'm not saying as a get back instantly. I'm saying they worked on it. Years went by. And then shit just switched.
I mean, it could happen, cheated. But at the same time, I just feel like if I cheat, I don't think you will take me back. And if I cheat on you sexually, if I cheat on you mentally or even sexually, I don't feel like it'll be.
I said it in the last video that I would leave if she cheated on me. But I said this to her before and I meant it. That she deserved. I deserve. Oh, shit.
We got some veggie nuggets inside the refrigerator. I mean, in the oven, y'all. Oh, okay. Now you the edit king.
Anyway, now I said this to her, and I said this to her, and I meant it. That she can get one get back on me. She's not the kind of person. She's not the kind of person. But just to prove to her that because I always say this all the time, you cheated on me, I'm done. Fuck that. But on a serious note, if she was to, I would take her back. Just one time. I would. I swear to God, I would. But so I would make it awkward as fuck, though, because now I'm like, so. I don't know. I'll be petty, but at the same time, I'll take it back. That wouldn't be every day. Like, yes, a younger me would be petty and bring it up all the time.
So I got a question. I'm sorry, y'all. This is crazy. And that's a question, but I got to ask it. So what if it was like your situation, just like yours?
What you mean, just like
I cheated with that many women? I mean, different men.
Oh, now you gonna hold in.
But it's the same situation as you.
But do you not hear what I just said, though? I just said you get one get back.
And that's my one get back. You found out that once. I only found out you cheated, even though you cheated on me several times. I found out that one time. So you found out all at once.
That you were a slut whore. And I need to leave you. The fuck? Men and women are not we're not equal. Fuck.
Y'all.
Women rights, civil rights, all that stuff. Hey. Not saying fuck the people who went through it. Thank you for getting us where we at today. All I'm saying is men and women are not equal. We're not the same.
And let me say this, y'all. He's saying all this to say that's how we run our relationship. Okay?
We're not the same.
Because I don't want nobody to be like, oh my God, he abusing her.
No,
it ain't nothing like that.
She slapped the fuck out
right,
of me.
Because I ain't no
punk bitch.
But
what I'm saying is this. I am a provider for our family. She is the household control person. You know what I'm saying?
Control person.
She controlled anything. I can go outside. Once I come in the house, even though I'm the provider, I got the last say so. Still got to go through her. You know what I'm saying? She runs the shit. It is what it is. What I'm saying is, we're not equal. So, same thing with sex. I cheated, that's wrong. If she cheat, I take her back. But if I was fucked a bunch of women, it is what it is. She fucked a bunch of men, she's a whore. That's what it is. And I'm a male whore. I'll be a male whore, but society see it, and I see it as, oh, what? Look at this man, got all those bitches. But she do it, it be like, I don't give a fuck if y'all love Nicki Minaj, Kim.
Don't try to play Nicki Minaj. You mean Amber Rose.
Amber Rose, too. Like, all that slut shame. Slut walk. That's still the word slut is in the front of it. And they glorifying it.
Changing
your kids
the
have to see that when they get older. Then what you gonna say to your kids?
What you gonna say to your kids? Your son? What you gonna say to your son when his my daddy be fucking bitches? So that's what I could do.
It's wrong, bro. But don't do it. But at the same time, how you gonna explain to your son and daughter? Mom's on camera sucking and fucking a bunch of people.
The same way you explain daddy is fucking and sucking a different people.
Look, that's just not what it is, man.
All right, y'all, let me quit playing with this boy. Okay, y'all, we know that already. But we know we are more traditional over here, and I'm okay with that.
We not that traditional because she be beating me. Fuck.
What I be doing, baby?
The other day, you slapped me and ripped my glasses out, cut my nose and everything.
What happened? Anyway. Tell our friends what happened, baby. No, tell them. It's okay. This is a safe place.
What happened? She had a flashback from whatever happened. From my past transgressions, and I guess I didn't respond the way she wanted me to respond. So she started throwing shit, hit me in my head, threw the control, the PlayStation controller at me. The mannequin with the wig on and hit me, knocked my glasses off, ripped my class shirt off.
First of all,
I just got my class shirt and ripped my shirt up. Gotta buy another one.
You had that for a year.
It was last year, about 6 months.
No.
At the end of the day, I wanted my fucking shit, and she ripped my shit off.
What else happened?
I pushed you off, and I almost called 911, but I didn't want the MPs to come, so I ran downstairs, locked the door, and waited until the hurricane.
You waited for a whole 24 hours, or?
No, about 30 minutes. And let the hurricane pass.
And it passed.
Yep.
And you're still alive. Look at God. Won't he do it?
I'm from Louisiana. I know how to survive through a hurricane.
Wow. All right, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, hit the notification bell so y'all can know when we dropping these fires. Put some comments down there, what y'all agree with, what y'all don't agree with. I am an open book, y'all. Y'all don't have to call each other and tell each other and text each other about anything I say. You can always call or text me. You can email me. I respond. Y'all know I don't have a job. All I do is make candles and try to play with babies all day, literally. Clean, cook, make lunches, and exercise.
Days, so don't say clean and cook. Clean, we ain't cooking
today. Well, since we on this coke. Where the fuck did I get coke from?
You might be high right now.
On coke.
But anyway, like you said, man, you don't gotta do all that petty shit being messy, man. But I think that comes with it. Just like you know how. With paparazzi, with celebrities, they put their business out so the whole world knows who they dating and they personal.
But see, you know what my problem is? Is my problem isn't even. You know what, y'all? We gonna make this on an unpopular video, so we can let this go down because I want to talk about that on another video. Peace.